the way we have been doing business in the past and the way we are doing business now is changing significantly. It's very, very relevant in today's context that we are all living in a world where we are digitally savvy. Now, when I talk about being digitally savvy, it is not just a theory, but I think we need to practice it in many ways. A lot of practices that we have been adopting in the past are now constantly changing. Significant amount of role that data analytics play, a significant amount of role that robotic process automation plays, artificial intelligence, blockchain, etc. are not the buzzwords, but I think these are products that extensively corporates have been using. And some of these products that we have now started using in our company, not all of them that I mentioned, but a few of them are under experiment and few of them are actually under use. My top priorities would be that how do I use digital technology to leverage on informed decision making, because there is so much of data and there's so much of informed data that you can use for the purpose of projecting your business for future. It also gives you certain signals of risk that are associated with your business. It also gives you the geographies in terms of where you're doing well, where you're not doing well, what are the strategies that will work in a particular geography. So we will be extensively using the digital technology for these purposes. So for a large organization like ours, it's very, very essential. There are a variety of areas where compliance is are a must. What we've done is that we've used certain very effective tools, for example, legal compliance tool. We work on the internal control and risk matrix tool. We also have done some e-modules where we keep sensitizing our teams in terms of how compliances have to be executed. And first and foremost is the understanding of the law and the compliance requirements within the company. So some of these downturns are good lessons for you to learn in terms of looking at your organization a little more closely and understanding all bits of costs associated with it. We are in particular working very hard on the indirect areas because we think that over a period there's a lot of lab that you accumulate in these areas. And what are the productivity measures and technology interventions that you can use to bring those costs down? So we are, for example, looking at solutions in spend management, travel, our travel management, etc., where we think that there is significant scope to bring the cost down. I think there are many companies now who are kind of evolving in this. Some of them have done very well. One very good example is the Big Four, who demonstrate a very good use of technology all the time and great learning from them in terms of how they manage some of their pieces. There are a lot of multinationals that I have been talking to with my peers who have done it very well. Companies like Unilever, etc., have demonstrated the use of technology very well. So there are a variety of companies you can learn from. So there are a variety of areas. I think transformation is an ongoing process, and I think the first and foremost thing is that you have to be well networked to understand where are the scope of doing more transformation. And we have a team of, we have an executive board where we have a team of 5 people who represent the entire verticals within the company. So we are, you know, very well versed in terms of what work goes on in which area and what is the scope of transformation in all these areas. So I, along with my IT head, work very closely with all of them in terms of looking at various transformations that we have been doing. For example, you know, this whole concept of connected cars has come in now, which was never thought of before. This has so much of data in it that you can figure out in terms of customer preferences, in terms of usage of car and so on and so forth. There is this blockchain solution, you know, where you can seamlessly look at the complete ecosystem, the entire supply chain system, and it works very seamlessly. And not only that it works seamlessly, it also reduces the cost and increases the productivity significantly. Artificial intelligence, for example, you know, we've been started using off late. It gives you such beautiful information on market, on sales trends, on and also your ability to predict for future. So I think all of these are now being driven by us in terms of the areas that we work with our team members. So what we've done is that over the past few years, the reviews that I take with my departments, because you get the crux of the entire company when you take these reviews, is largely focused on operational review is a very limited portion, but I think I largely concentrate on the data analytics. So I will, for example, tell them that you please analyze your areas, these pieces of data, and bring a report to me. And some very interesting data points come in when, you know, they show this picture. And they're also very excited because it's something they have been doing new. And they feel there's a lot of value that they bring into the table. And some of them have been so significant that, you know, it gives you tremendous opportunity both in terms of business and in terms of your bottom line. So we have been using that very extensively now. So I would say what I mentioned at the beginning, that data analytics is first and prime, because that gives you a significant insight into your business. How do you move forward? What are the trends and so on? And then all the productivity and cost measures like blockchain, artificial intelligence for more better planning. And I think these are some, and connected cars, as I mentioned to you, because in our business, that's very significant. So some of these measures are, and spend management, the other area where you actually look at what are the trends in the market and what is the best way of dealing with it. So these are the areas that we are looking at.